Umeme has steadily recovered from a major slump experienced between the months of April to July, where the utility company's revenue dipped to about 76%.
The sector was growing at 9% January, February. Then COVID came in March, and everything went upside down. Our revenue collections dropped to as low as 76%. The sector has lost more than $40 million of would-be revenues for this year. Our customers still want more reliable power, therefore we cannot sit and hide. I'm glad to know that we have almost concluded our $80 million investment program that we laid out.
Despite the challenges in 2020 due to COVID-19, the private sector company has managed to upgrade its electricity network and injected over 100 new transformers in different parts of the country. Jinja and Mukono areas are among the major beneficiaries of supply stabilization.
We are building three new lines, one going to National Water dedicated, Katosi. Another one going to Tiangtang. Tiangtang wants another 15 megawatts of power there. We expanded their industry. Actually, they are waiting for us to kickstart their industry. Then the third one is going to reinforce the Mbarara industrial area. So we believe this will relieve Mukono substation to provide better quality power to this industrial growth in this area.
Improvement of quality of power supply to residential areas, townships, schools, health centers, among others, is top priority in 2021.
We believe after the elections, you remember we were engaging with the government on the concession extension, so we believe after the elections we'll close out on that project of engaging with the government. And this is very important for the country because when you have an extended contract, you can mobilize more long-term capital to invest in the network.
According to Celestino Babunji, the managing director of Umeme, the growing demand from commercial, industrial and residential customers calls for efficiency in electricity distribution. Dennis Sigoa and Robin Yoso for UBC Business.